Hey, hello everybody, this is Ibrahim with another Godot Game Engine tutorial. Today we are gonna be making tic-tac-toe game. If you're not familiar with the tic-tac-toe game, pause this video, Google it, play it, I think you'll find it. So yeah, let's get started. First of all, go ahead and make a new project, make a new scene, add a new Node2D, name it as you like, and attach a new GDescript to it, and we are ready to go. The tic-tac-toe game is a 3x3 grid, and this prototype that we are going to make, I want it to be extendable, so it could be used in another game with another concept. So we need to give it a size attribute. In this case it is 3x3, and we need a cell size. Let's say 50 pixel, and for sure we need a player. Let's say X is going to start, and definitely we need a board, an array, and position array. This array is representing the grid cell's position. So we need a function that format the board array with empty strings, and here it is. So for A in range size, for J in range size, each time we are appending an empty string to the tab array, and when we get out of the inner loop, we append that tab to the board array and empty that tab, and so on. So we need also a function that format the pose array. It is very similar to the previous function, but here we are each time we are append a vector to with pos x pos y, and each time we are adding the cell size to that to the x's and the y's. So after executing this function, we should have an array of arrays with the first cell, it is 0 0, the second would be 50 on the x-axis and 0 on the y-axis, and so on. So let's call that function and see the result, and print the pose array. Run. So yeah, here it is, the result. It is an array of arrays that contain all the cells, the grid cells positions. I think we need to resize the screen depending on the grid size and the cell size. So here it is, the function resize screen takes size as argument. We have the predefined set window size method. This method change the screen size from the class OS. So let's call that function resize screen. Give it the size here. Run. Here we go. In our case, it is a 3x3 grid with 50 pixels cell size. It would be 50 by times 3, 150 pixel each size. So let's move on and draw some stuff. First of all, any draw commands should be under the draw function. We are going to draw the grid. Here it is. So we have J variable starts from 0, and for loop, each time we're going to draw a line from 0 to J, which is 0, starting from 0 0. The second argument is the end point. It's going to be cell size times size, that's 180, and J 0. The last argument is the color of the line we are drawing. This is the horizontal lines, the opposite for the vertical lines. So let's test this. Run. Here we go. three vertical, two vertical lines and two horizontal lines. Guys, I am copying and pasting stuff to gain some extra time, and honestly I can't try it and explain at the same time. Now let's make some action here. We need to add the new input action. So we go project, project setting, input map, and we need to add new action. Gonna call it, sorry, click add. Here you need to add the event. It is mouse left click event, so add it. Let's go back here. We need to call the input function, sorry, input event. I'm gonna say if, scroll down, input dot is action just pressed, click as we name it. Gonna print something, print clicked, let's say test. What's the problem? Okay, click, click it, click, clicked, as you can see. Now, after we detect the click on the screen, we need to know where the click is. So I'm going to write function. Here it is, get clicked cell. We are giving it p vector 2 position as argument. Or for a in range size inner loop, for j in range size, each time we are comparing that p with each pose array cell. So we are see if and x axis is bigger than each cell and less than pose inj dot x plus cell size, we are comparing it with the boundaries of each cell on the x axis and same on the y axis. When we get this, we are going to return these INJ because the GD script is a high level dynamic typing language. We could return two values or two variables in a function. So we are going to handle this on the event. We're going to have a var cell equal get clicked cell. Yeah, we are to put the event dot position as argument and print that cell test, click here. So yeah, that is the 00 cell, this would be the 22 cell, so on. So after we detect the clicked cell, we need to know if that cell is valid. It means it is empty and we can place something there. So let's write a function. This is check pose is valid. It's going to take INJ as a parameter and return boolean. So we're going to say if a border INJ is equal empty string, means that position is valid, we are going to return true, else return false. Let's handle this here. Going to say if check pose is valid cell of 0 and cell of 1. If that is true, print okay. But let's make sure we call the create border function. Okay. There we go. Okay, okay. Because the all the border is empty, any cell is going to return okay. Now we detect the clicked cell and we know if it is valid one. So we can place something there. To play means to put something in that specific cell and switch player's turn. So let's write switch player's function. It's easy if that player is X, then change it to O. If the player is O, change it to X. Easy. And now let's write the play function. That's it. Okay. Play, it's going to take the coordinates I and j, and that cell we just put the player there. In our case, player is x, so we're going to put x in that cell and switch players and print it's the next player term. And update this function, it's going to redraw, because the draw function called one time. We need to recall to redraw the board. Now we are actually just drawing the grid, so let's draw the board array to visualize something. And because the board array is an array of strings, we need to load a new font to use it. I have that font here, another round. I downloaded from dafont.com. You'll find it the description zone. You can load the resource from here, a new type dynamic font. Can do it from here, but I'm going to load it from the script. So var font equal dynamic font dot new, and let's go to the ready function. Okay, and load something here. So font dot font data attribute equal load. Let's copy the path of that font, copy path, paste, that's it. And let's give it a size, font dot size, I think, yes, dot size equal, let's give it the cell size. So after we load the font, now we can start drawing the board. So here it is, two for loops as usual, because we are working on an array of arrays. And we have the draw string method. That method draw a string or character on the screen. So the parameters of it is the font that we loaded and the position where you want to draw your string, and the string itself from the board array, and the color, give it black color. So we need also to call the play function, because we didn't call it. Play cell 0, cell 1. Let's test this. It is working, but we have a problem. We need to shift them down. Let's go back to the draw. We are going to shift them down on the x-axis. You are going to shift them by 20% of the cell size multiplied by 0.2, 20%. And on the y-axis, I think we are going to add 80% of the size, cell size, sorry, dot y plus cell size multiplied by 0.8, means 80%. You can play with these numbers to get the right spot, you know. Let's test that. Yeah, it's working. As you can see, we play and the players switched. Now we have the mechanism of playing. You know, it is a two-player game. You can apply some algorithm, make a function that pick a random spot to make it playable against the computer, or you can go to the next level by applying some artificial intelligence algorithms to make it unbeatable tic-tac-toe. Check out the Minimax algorithm for this. Now we need to continue. We need to check the winning conditions. We have three different situations. If we got three horizontal, vertical, or diagonal marks in a row, we have a winner. Or none of these if it is a draw. This is the winning function. It's not a code, but believe me, it's not a big deal. So we have two for loops as usual. We have var test, an array with two true values. Each time I'm formatting it with two true values. Here, the row test. Each time we are comparing the first cell in the row with each cell, if they are different or that cell is empty, so we change the true to false. And same for the column, but here we are comparing with the first in the column, so 0i, here i 0. So when we get out of that for loop, if the value is still true, means we have a winner. That's for the column and the row testing. Here for the diagonal test, the same. We have an array with two true values. We have a j for loop. Each time we are comparing the ii cell with the first, so with the 00 cell. So 00 is different than 11 and 22. That's the diagonal row. And this is the other diagonal. If the array is still true, means we have a winner. Now we need to check the other condition, which is draw. This is the function. So check draw. We have k variable equals to 0 for a in range, for j in range, to loops. If border I and j is different than empty, so we have something in that cell. We have the k variable plus 1. When we get out of these two loops, we see if k equals size power 2. So, sorry, size power 2 means how much cell we have in the border. In our case, size is 3, so 3 times 2 equals 9. If we have 9 filled cells, means it's a draw. We return true, else we return false. Let's merge the latter two functions in a one function. So function is game finished. So we have var winner, check winner the function. If winner is different null, means we have a winner, print that winner is winner and return true. Else if check draw is true, means it is draw, print draw and return true, else we return false. Now let's handle this in the input event. So after we play, we are going to check if the game is finished. So if is game finished, if that is true, we are going to set the process input to false. In my case, I'm going just to set the process input to false, so the player can't click anymore. You can add a replay button, or it would take you to another scene. That is up to you guys. List is this. So XO, XO turn, X turn, X is winner, and we can't click anymore. X is winner. Let's test this again with the O. So X O, X O, X. This is O. We can't click anymore. We have a winner. Three O's in a row. So we have a winner. As I mentioned at the beginning of this video, Stick-Tac-Toe is extendable. So let's try this on a bigger scale. Scroll up. Let's try a 5x5 tic-tac-toe. Here we go. It's a 5x5 tic-tac-toe. The same condition of the winning is applied here. So we have X winner. Where is the X? Here it is. Diagonal. We could try a bigger one. Let's say 10x10 tic-tac-toe. This is the ultimate tic-tac-toe. This is the biggest, I think, the biggest tic-tac-toe board have ever made. Man, that's a remastered version of tic-tac-toe. Have some imagination here. You can build another game on this concept or on this board. So yeah, I think we did it. That was my proposition for a two-player tic-tac-toe game. Maybe someone else have another point of view here. There is many ways to do it. Anyways, I hope you understand my explanation. If you like such content, give this video thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. You'll find the source down below this video. Thanks for being here. Till the next time, see you soon.